Unfinished King of DIY aquarium projects. Man, I've got a lot of them. Some of you will remember that we went in the house at one point during a past video and we talked about me cleaning up my utility room. And there's probably a ton of projects. I just kind of began doing that and I already stumbled across, two or three. Today I thought we'd go over what these projects are, why I didn't complete them, and should I continue with them? This came the other day from Sweden. Linda sent a nice letter. The beautiful drawing of a discus. That's really nice. Very cool. Just gonna open a couple of mail packages from you guys. This one came from Nally. Oh, this is interesting. I wanted to share my invention with you and send you a sample to use. Ooh. Website, mermaidandpirate.com. This is actually really cool. Check this out. She tells a story about sucking up one of her pets through her siphon. So she invented this. A siphon. Save a fishy siphon safety cap. Proudly made in USA from start to finish. This is cool. Watch. So say you're siphoning your aquarium. Obviously, this is a 2-foot version, but you always have this open end. Fish can get sucked up to it, etc. Take the siphon stopper. Oh, it goes right over it. Now that is actually a pretty cool invention for what it is. Wow. She sent a few sizes as well. If you guys invent things and send it to me, I don't mind giving you guys a shout out because I think this is useful and pretty cool. For something so simple, I'm not sure if it's ever been used before. Of course, there's gonna be people say you could just get a PVC cap, drill some holes in it, etc. Not everybody's as handy or has the tools. But this, for as simple as it is brilliant. Now you can put it in your tanks and leave it there, doing your water changes, not worry about your fish getting sucked up. Or decorations, or too much substrate, or whatever the case might be. I would probably put this on after I do a gravel vacuuming. But maybe I'll try it out without. Or giving you a code for your subscribers, I'll give you $1 for it. I don't need to be paid, it's fine. Please check out my Facebook page. Hey, this is just pretty cool. You guys can search up mermaidandpirate.com. Natalie, that's pretty cool. Mermaid and Pirate Aquarium Supply. That's pretty cool. This is actually really useful. Now, my projects and inventions. Not gonna be as useful or as cool as that, but yeah, they're pretty cool. Okay, first and foremost, I have a bunch of these things. This isn't a project, but this is something that every aquarium should have. Wait till you see what it is. So before the gallery and before this entire building was on GFCI, which stands for Ground Fault Circuit Interrupter, meaning if something gets wet, you're not gonna get electrocuted and it just trips it. You'll find these in your bathrooms. By law, they've gotta be in your bathrooms and by your kitchen sink, any near water source. You'll have a plug with a trip and a test. So basically, you could turn any plug into GFCI. You just plug it into the wall, plug in your aquarium equipment, and you're good to go. I think these are less than 10 bucks, but if you have an aquarium and it's not on a GFCI plug, go get one, plug it into your wall, and plug this in, peace of mind. It also is a surge protector, so you don't fry your equipment. But most importantly, you don't electrocute yourself or your family or anybody around it, because we have all, maybe more so me, had water accidents. But yeah, I had all of these. So this will handle 1800 watts, 120 volts, 15 amps. Anyway, such a simple piece of equipment. I found a bunch of these because, like I said, I used to use all of them. Now this entire building is on GFCI based on the, 5,000 or 6,000 gallons that are in it. But go pick one up. Let's get on to these things. These are kind of exciting because when I started finding these things, I was like, what the heck was I thinking? What is this stuff? Like, what is this motor for? Then I remembered. So a lot of this stuff, I kind of started putting it together and then moved on. The gallery got in the way when I first started building all of this. Didn't have a ton of time for it, but I do remember a few of these things and what they were actually intended for. originally. Come here. Okay, this one is actually going to be put into use. I just haven't yet. It's very plug and play. If you're not sure what this is, it's a water meter. Obviously, I have more work to do here in terms of twist ties, but okay. So you'd have to purchase all of this separately. I think I got it on eBay or Amazon, something along those lines. But the way this works, I think, let me see here. It should work. Okay, yeah, so this is definitely gonna be plug and play. Look, very simple. Little one goes in the little one. Big one goes in the big one. Pretty simple. What the hell these are for? What the hell is this for? I don't know what this is for. I do know that this is a temperature probe. I don't know if it can go in, might be just go in your water or something like that. Anyways, let's jump to what this is actually about. I have to turn this on. So we got a power supply, we got a meter, and we have the actual component here. Now, this is the interesting thing. You see the arrow pointing this way. Water comes in through it. There's nothing restricting the flow, you guys can see in there, except, see it spin? Very little bit of pressure or air will cause it to spin. Anyways, what's happening is, as water's flowing through this, it's going to meter and tell you exactly what your gallons per hour or liters per hour or minute will be. This one's rated for something like 3,100 gallons per hour or 200 liters per minute. So what I would do is put this in line on my pumps to the 2000 probably, after the pump as the return, and now I'll be able to monitor the flow of the water. So if it slows down, I'll know that I'm gonna have to do some maintenance. I always have to take these off. Oh, I love that. Okay. So I don't even know if this is still any good. I had flooding problems, so I'm gonna actually plug this in and see. Does it work or did I fry it? I might have fried it. See? It's getting like a surge. Oh, there it goes. Oh! Okay. So, it's currently telling the temperature of the air out here. If you can see that without the glare, 29 degrees Celsius. That is what the temperature is. There's no flow going through it, so I'll get an all-time flow and current flow. I'm not sure what else it does, but let's try blowing through it, see what that does. Maybe it only senses water. It needs to have actual water pumping through it. Oh, it has a minimum. So I have to blow, I think, 10 liters of air per minute, which I don't think is possible. No, I'm not gonna be able to pump this fast enough. But you get the idea, just a cool little gadget. I think this was less than 10 bucks for everything. Again, like Amazon. No, this had to have been eBay because it's all like Chinese type stuff. But yeah, I'll probably continue to build this or actually install it. For what it is, it will allow me to monitor the flow of the pump. If the canister is getting dirty and the flow starts, I'll just know sooner. You get the idea. Plus, it's just interesting to know everything that's going on with your aquariums. This one, okay, this is a project that is not gonna make sense. So we all know about power heads, wave makers, etc., things that cause circulation within the aquarium to make your aquariums much more healthy. But for example, this one here is stationary. You put it in your aquarium and it stays like that. So I was like, couldn't I build something that rotates it? But couldn't I also build it to rotate as fast or as slow as I wanted to? So I started piecing some things together. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna keep doing this project because it's just interesting, it's fun, but I don't need it anymore, so I kind of like just stopped working on it. We have a cheap power supply, just a simple AC adapter. You can get these on Amazon, or I'm sorry, eBay for like a dollar. We have the controller itself, CCM5D. I'm not sure what the hell that means, but maybe I should bring up my orders and find out where everything came from. I can't remember. I've got two or three of these though. But as you can see, it's very simple to follow. I've already kind of started hooking it up, but I don't think I went any further than that. Then we have an on-off switch. This is also maybe a dollar. I think this was like $2. Everything was dollars, like just a couple bucks. Then we have a limiter switch. So this will control the speed. So whatever I plug into this, this is going to control how much power it's going to it and the speed of it. So this might look familiar to like a lot of hobbyists that work with like toy cars or something, I'm guessing. This does 60 RPM, so 60 rotations per minute. What happens if I hook up a power? Oh, can you even see that? I'm not good at these do-it-yourself projects anymore, these do-it-yourself videos. So what happens is if we hook up to a power supply to this, this little bar here is going to start to spin. What does that mean? Well, I'll get to that in a second. First, let's see if it's actually going to work. Now, the motor itself, I don't know if it has a positive and negative terminal, but I think it does. Look at these tiny little wires, so clearly I was just checking to see if everything works. I don't think I actually hooked the motor up yet at this point in stage, but there's probably about 15 to 20 unfinished projects. As you can imagine, doing do-it-yourself projects for I think the first 7 years of this channel, you have to constantly be building something. Whether it works or not, you can't invest all of your time into one project, because at the end of the day, if it doesn't work, you can't really make a video about that. So I was always building, always trying things, always testing, etc., etc. Unfortunately, it was the least sustainable channel idea that I've ever had. Very expensive, very time consuming. Videos used to take me 20 to 40 hours to make. This channel was costing me a couple grand a month. I wasn't even making that. For the first, I think, 6 years of this channel, I ran a deficit, meaning that I was not making money. I was losing money every month. There are some negative side effects to that. Perhaps that's a video in the future, though. Okay, I think it's hooked up now. You guys want to come have a closer look? All right, so mind you, these are live wires. I can't be touching them. But this is just a test phase. So what I was going to do is build a box for this, slide this into it. I was going to have everything, probably look at it this way. I was going to have everything facing outwards, something like this. Like when we built that heater controller and put it in a black acrylic box. Let's just plug this in and see if it works. Then I'll explain what I was up to. Oh, it's working. Oh, so this is cool. Oh, it's spinning. Can you see that? Let me just hold it. I don't want to twist the wires, but you see that? Now, so it's doing, let me just shut it off. Oh, the power switch works. So watch. Hit the power switch, and that's cool, eh? So when it comes to a lot of projects and looking to build something, a lot of it just comes down to being creative and using ideas that you already know work. There's 100, so that's gonna do 60 RPM. Turn it down. Oh, this is too cool. I need to finish this project. 2 RPM, it's going so slow. You can see this here spinning slightly, and we speed it up. See it going now? It's not that fast, but it's fast enough. So, but it's very controllable, very touchy. Let's go 50%. Yeah, that is awesome. Flip the switch. Oh, I love this. I gotta finish it. There's a lot of other cool projects down in my basement in the house that need to get finished that I never have, but I did wanna show you guys a couple little things that I just grabbed off, well, the top of a box, basically. I'm going to put this to use. I need to finish this just because it's a cool project, but anyways, I'd have to encapsulate this in a waterproof box, probably just some sort of a seal. Maybe I just do like a Rubbermaid container for food and have all wires and whatnot. Only have this bar coming out. But anyways, with this bar spinning, what I was thinking I could do is attach some sort of a pipe. I'd have to build some sort of a mechanism anyways that would allow this to spin and then reset, go back, spin again, reset, go back, spin again. So to put it into perspective, this is on a bar or a pipe or whatever the case might be. So it spins, resets, goes back. Wouldn't that be cool if I could build that? and for very little money. I don't remember specifically what everything cost on this. I do know power adapters because I bought so many of them, are like a dollar. This limiter is a dollar. The power switch is a dollar. So we're $3 into this. The little motor, you might be looking at like $5, and this is just China made. I think I'm about $20 into this project, maybe less, maybe $15, something like that. Yeah, that was pretty cool. Anyways, I gotta finish some of these projects. There's a ton of other videos I wanna work on, but there's a lot of things that I might never get to, but that doesn't mean you guys can't see them, because there might have been something within these little projects that you find some inspiration from or get some ideas from or whatever the case might be. If you guys think I should finish those projects or just start tackling the other ones, they do take a tremendous amount of time to not only gather all the materials, test them, do it in various ways, source the materials that so you guys can actually find them, film them, build it, test it, etc., blah, 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 20 to 40 hours per video. That's why at one point I was only making one video per week. But I don't know, I still enjoy doing them when they're fun like that. I forgot how interesting those ones were, so let me know in the comment section below if I should finish those or show you guys some other unfinished projects from the king of DIY. Or maybe I should just finish all the projects that I started out here. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Oh, before you guys go, if you guys haven't heard about it, my contest is still ongoing. I released it the other day. I know many of you haven't heard about it and would be upset if it passed and you didn't. So link is in the description below. If you don't know, I'm doing a contest that will fly you plus one out to meet me and hang out with me for the weekend in Texas. All inclusive, no cost to you. Link is in the description. Make sure you check it out.